या एम आई ऑडिबल नाउ? फाइन, लेट अस स्टार्ट रिकॉर्डिंग द लेक्चर. वेलकम टू माय बॉडी प्लॉट्स लेक्चर. नाउ दिस लेक्चर, इन दिस लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू द न्यू कंसेप्ट ऑफ हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द गेन मार्जिन एनालिटिकली. मीन्स लास्ट टाइम in the lecture we have seen how to calculate the gain margin graphically, which is identify the phase crossover frequency, extend the line above and see the vertical distance between the magnitude plot and the 0 dB line, which is our x-axis. So the distance between the 0 dB line and the point where the phase crossover frequency line cuts the magnitude plot. So the point, the frequency at which the Bode phase plot cuts 180 degree line is called as phase crossover frequency. And if you extend this phase crossover frequency over the magnitude plot and cut the magnitude plot here, and you measure the vertical distance between 0 dB line and this point, this will give you the gain margin. So the red line over here will show you how to graphically identify the gain margin from Bode plot. Now understand one more thing. If you say that the point is above 0 dB, that is if you are measuring the distance above 0 dB, the magnitude above 0 dB, the gain margin is considered as negative here. So understand it very well. Gain margin measured above 0 dB is always negative in Bode plots. Similarly, what is phase margin graphically? How to identify it? First, identify the gain crossover frequency. What is gain crossover frequency? It is such a frequency where the magnitude plot cuts the 0 dB line. That is where the magnitude becomes 1, because 20 log of 1 is 0, because log of 1 itself is 0. So wherever the magnitude becomes 1, there the line is 0 dB. So it cuts the 0 dB line here. And therefore we can say that this is called as the gain crossover frequency. The frequency at which the Bode magnitude plot cuts the 0 dB line. Now extend this line below and see where the line cuts our phase plot. So see the phase plot. And here the line cuts vertically the phase plot at this point, somewhere over here, wherever the cursor is pointing. And now you have to measure the vertical distance of this point from 180 degree line, that is x-axis. So measure the distance from this 180 degree line to the point where it cuts the phase plot. So this distance will be phase angle in degrees from 180 degree. So here the phase angle is minus 9 degree. So here you have to assume below 180 degree you have to measure as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Because one division is 9 degree here. The distance between the blocks is 45 degrees. So there are 5 divisions. So one division will be 9 degree. 9 phi will be 45, and this point is exactly one line below the 180 degree. So this is minus 9 degree. So understand the phase margin is negative if it is below 180 degree. And this is how you identify the phase margin from the Bode plot. So this is graphical identification. But what we are going to see today is how to calculate the gain margin and phase crossover frequency mathematically. Now what is gain margin? Understand it very properly. Gain margin is reciprocal of the magnitude of gain at phase crossover frequency, which means mathematically you can write gain margin is equal to, reciprocal means 1/, and magnitude of gain is nothing but magnitude of g of j omega into h of j omega. So mod sign means magnitude at omega is equal to omega PC, means at phase crossover frequency. Now, first we need to calculate what is omega PC. Okay. Now, how to calculate omega PC from a given open loop transfer function mathematically? So let us take G of S into H of S is equal to 1 upon S into S plus 1 into S plus 2 as a transfer function, some open loop transfer function. Now for this, we have to calculate the phase crossover frequency. We know that phase crossover frequency is the frequency at which the phase angle of the function is minus 180 degree. So put S is equal to J omega in the above transfer function. So write the transfer function again by putting S is equal to J omega. So let us put S is equal to J omega and write the transfer function again. So it is G of J omega into H of J omega is equal to 1 upon, for S, write J omega. So this will be 1 plus J omega. This will be 2 plus J omega. So your transfer function will be like this. Now, how to calculate the angle? Numerator is 1. So you can see the numerator here, it is 1. It can be written as 1 plus J0 in complex form. Now, angle of A plus JB, which is a complex number, is given as tan inverse of B upon A. That is tan inverse of imaginary part divided by real part. What is the real, what is the imaginary part? B. What is the real part? A. Now, what is the angle of 1 plus J0? 1 plus J0 is tan inverse of imaginary part is 0 divided by real part is 1. So tan inverse 0 by 1. So tan inverse 0 by 1 is tan inverse 0, which will be equal to what? 0 degree. So 0 degree is the angle of the numerator. So numerator angle is 0 degree. Now next, we have to calculate the angle of the denominator. There are three factors in the denominator, as you see. One is J omega. One is J omega. So what is the factor J omega? That factor can be written as 0 plus J omega. Now we know angle of A plus JB is tan inverse of B upon A. So similarly, angle of omega 0 plus J omega will be tan inverse of omega by 0. Now anything divided by 0 is always infinity. So tan inverse of infinity becomes 90 degree. So this angle will be 90 degree. Whatever is the value of omega, the angle will always be equal to what? 90. So if there is a single pole at origin in transfer function, so this is single pole at origin, the angle in the denominator will always be 90 for that pole, 90 degree. So whatever is the frequency, the angle will remain constant. Now, let us see the second angle, the second factor, 1 plus J omega. For 1 plus J omega, angle of 1 plus J omega is tan inverse of omega by 1. So imaginary by real. Now tan inverse of omega by 1 is what? Tan inverse of omega. Now third factor, 2 plus J omega. So what is the angle of 2 plus J omega? The angle of 2 plus J omega is tan inverse omega by 2. So imaginary part divided by real part. So tan inverse of omega by 2. Now these three angles are the angles in the denominator. Now when the angles are multiplied in the denominator, they will get added. So this will be 90 plus tan inverse of omega plus tan inverse of omega by 2 in the denominator. And in the numerator, it is 0. So understand, in the numerator, the angle is 0 degree. In the numerator, the angle is 0. And in the denominator, the angle is the addition of three factors. First one is 90 degree, 90 plus. Second one is tan inverse of omega, this one, and third one is plus tan inverse of omega by 2. So angle in the denominator is 90 plus tan inverse of omega plus tan inverse of omega by 2. So this will be in the denominator, and numerator angle is 0. Now total angle is calculated by subtracting the denominator angle from the numerator. So it is angle of numerator minus angle of denominator. So phase angle is given as angle of numerator minus angle of denominator. So what is angle of numerator? 0. What are the angles in the denominator? So it was plus 90, but there is a minus sign here, so it will become minus 90. So there was plus tan inverse omega. Since there is a minus sign here, it will become minus tan inverse omega and minus tan inverse of omega by 2. So this will be the total angle. Minus 90, minus tan inverse omega, minus tan inverse omega by 2. Now, but for calculating phase crossover frequency, this phase angle should be minus 180 degree. So equate this phase angle to minus 180. So what you get? 0 minus 90 is minus 90. Minus tan inverse omega, minus tan inverse omega by 2 is equal to what? Minus 180. Equate it to minus 180. Because phase crossover frequency, as you have seen from the plot, is the frequency at which the phase angle cuts 180 degree, or the phase angle is exactly 180 degree or minus 180 degree. So for the same reason, we are equating here the whole phase angle of the Bode plot to minus 180 degree. Right? Now transfer this minus 90 to this side. So this will become minus 180 and this will be plus 90. Minus 180 plus 90 is minus 90. So minus tan inverse of omega, this will remain as it is here, and minus tan inverse of omega will remain as it is here on the left hand side, is equal to minus 90. Now, remove the negative signs from both the sides. So it will be tan inverse omega plus tan inverse omega by 2 is equal to plus 90. Now, this is the known format in mathematics, that is tan inverse of A plus tan inverse of B. The formula for this is tan inverse of A plus B upon 1 minus AB. So tan inverse of A plus B upon 1 minus AB is nothing but tan inverse A plus tan inverse B. So this looks like tan inverse A and this is tan inverse of B. So we are using the formula of tan inverse A plus tan inverse B, which is equal to tan inverse A plus B upon 1 minus AB. So let us use the formula. So tan inverse omega plus tan inverse omega by 2 is equal to tan inverse A plus B. What is A? Omega. What is B? Omega by 2. So A plus B means omega plus omega by 2 divided by 1 minus AB. So 1 minus A into B. So omega into omega by 2 will be omega square by 2. Right? So this will be tan inverse omega plus omega by 2 divided by 1 minus omega square by 2 is equal to what? 90. Now, tan inverse of theta is 90. So theta will be equal to tan 90. Tan inverse of a number is 90. So number will be equal to tan 90, right? So tan of 90 is nothing but omega plus omega by 2 divided by 1 minus omega square by 2. So we are just taking the tan of theta, that is 90 degree, and this will be as it is because it is tan inverse. Tan inverse of a number is 90. So this number will be tan of 90. So when I transfer this to this side, this will become tan of 90. Now, what is tan of 90? It is infinity. So omega plus omega by 2 upon 1 minus omega square by 2 will be equal to what? Infinity, because tan of 90 is infinity. Now, when is the number equal to infinity? When we divide any number by 0, it will become what? Infinity. So what should be the denominator in terms of infinity? The denominator should be equal to what? 0. Now, since this number, this ratio is infinity, the denominator must be 0. The denominator must be 0 because anything divided by 0 is what? Infinity. So let us equate the denominator to 0. So 1 minus omega square by 2 equal to 0. Omega square by 2 equal to 1. Transfer this one to this side. And omega square will become equal to 2. So 2 will come to this side. And omega will be equal to root 2, which is 1.414. So this is the phase crossover frequency, which is called as omega PC, which is equal to 1.414 in this case, radian per second. Now, how to calculate the gain margin? Gain margin is magnitude of g of j omega into h of j omega, which is 1 upon j omega into 1 plus j omega into 2 plus j omega. So magnitude of this. So what is the magnitude of j omega? It is omega, because it is under root 0 square plus omega square, which is omega. Now, what is the magnitude of 1 plus j omega? is under root real part square plus imaginary part square. What is the real part? 1. 1 square is 1 plus imaginary part is omega. So omega square. So this is square root. Now 2 plus j omega. What is the magnitude of 2 plus j omega? Under root real part square. 2 square is 4 and imaginary part square omega. Omega square. So this is the magnitude. Now we have to put omega pc is equal to 1.41 in this equation. So let us calculate the gain magnitude by putting omega value is equal to 1.41. So 1 upon this number is equal to 0.167. When I calculate by putting omega equal to 1.414, we get the value as 0.167. Now gain margin is reciprocal of 0.167. So reciprocal of 1 upon, you get 1 upon 0.167 because you are taking the reciprocal of gain magnitude. So it is equal to what? 6. Now gain margin in dB is 20 log of 6, which is equal to 15.56 dB, because gain margin is always measured in dB. You first take the magnitude of this transfer function, g of j omega into h of j omega, right? See here, g of j omega into h of j omega, in our case, our transfer function was 1 upon s into s plus 1 into s plus 2. And we substituted s is equal to j omega here, and we got a g of j omega into h of j omega. So you got this function. And when you take the magnitude of this function, you will get the magnitude as this value. See here, this value. So you have to take the individual magnitude. So magnitude of a plus jb, if you take the magnitude of a plus jb, it is under root a square plus b square. It is under root real part square plus imaginary part square. So j omega is 0 plus j omega. So 0 square plus omega square under root will be omega. Now this 1 plus j omega. So that will be under root 1 square plus omega square. Now this one under root 2 square 4 plus omega square. So this is how you calculate the magnitude. Okay. And put omega value. Omega value is equal to what? 1.414. So here if you see, this omega is substituted as 1.414. And this omega is also 1.414. This omega is also 1.414. After the calculation, we get the value at 0.167. Check this on your calculators. Once I get this value, we have to take the reciprocal to obtain the gain margin, because gain margin is reciprocal of this magnitude. So 1 upon 0.167 is 6. And we have to take 20 log of 6 to measure the gain margin in dB. So 20 log of 6 is nothing but 15.56 dB, because it is always measured in dB. So you have to take 20 log to the base 10, 6. So on your calci, you can do 20 log of 6 to convert this into dB. So 20 log of 6 is 15.56 dB. This is how you calculate the gain margin. Thank you very much.